Beyonce dropped her new music video for Formation the night before her Super Bowl performance of Formation, also announcing the Formation World Tour. I want you guys to watch the music video.
Now let's get information. I slay. Okay, ladies, now let's get information.
All right, so in the video, we see a lot of striking imagery, right? A lot of political relevance. We also have here in the video a sinking New Orleans police car. We saw at the very end a young kid in a black hoodie dancing in front of a lineup of cops. And then behind him, graffitied on the wall, was the words, quote, stop shooting us. So a lot of representation of the hashtag Black Lives Matter and imagery in there portraying that. I want to read some of the tweets because I feel like it kind of generalizes how people interpreted her video. We have here from Mickey Kendall, Beyonce was unapologetically black in this video, and she showed black American cultures that rarely get mainstream attention. We have here Preston Mitchum, Beyonce literally had a video that covered Katrina, police brutality, afros, baby hairs, Red Lobster, braids, hot sauce. Her quote on Red Lobster, like, mm-hmm. me right and I'll take you to Red Lobster. Mm-hmm. She's amazing. Elon James White, Beyonce was just black as shit, like she was black and then was like, no, I need more blackness up in the blackness. And then finally we have Star, Beyonce is so unapologetically black, it's beautiful. So what did you guys think about her music video about Formation?
Awesome.
This is a well done music video. Mm-hmm. Everything, I think the things that stand out for me are when the camera changes from like a high quality one to a handheld, old timey,
like
tape camera.
1990s, yeah.
Yeah, I think that's it. Where it's just like, oh my God, that is just a very simple, effective way to convey what everyone thinks when they, you know, see, especially because I watched Straight Outta Compton the same day and that O.J. Simpson show on FX. So now when I see like a VHS style handy cam, I'm like, oh, that's just, this is, police brutality. And it's just a very, and she didn't say that.
Right, it's
just
the imagery.
They just did it with one quick shot.
You're absolutely right.
It just, what I love about the video is that they're very rarely these days do you see a music video that immediately makes an impression, and every shot could have been a still image and it would have been just as powerful. And that's what I really liked about the video, is that a lot of thought went into it, on top of just great dance numbers, on top of, you know, just really stunning costumes and outfits. It's just so much more. And I love that. But what can we expect from Beyonce? Of course she's going to put that much care and thought
she
into
half
whatever
it,
she does.
But she's got such a big ass that's like someone else whole-assing it.
She's fierce as fuck. Like, so fierce when you watch it. There's so many moments that, like, I wanted to, like, go in front of a mirror and, like, imitate.
God, the money that I would pay to watch Sam just like.
I'm gonna close my eyes and picture that.
I could not do it, but stop it, Brett.
Her dog just sitting there going like, what's happening to mommy?
But I loved how politically charged it was. Mm-hmm. And I think it's really important. And of course, you know, when I was looking at the hashtag and most people were celebrating it, there were people being like, oh, can you imagine if this was a white performer singing White Pride or having imagery of White Pride? It's different, people. And let's talk about that. It's different because of the cultural history. It's different because, one, black history, there's a lot of oppression there. Still to this day, there's social injustices where there needs to be a movement. That's mm-hmm. why Black Lives Matter is important, because there is still there's still racism still exists today. But I hate it that people pit people against each other. They think, okay, black versus white, when it's not, when you can't.
It happens. When you say us, it implies a them. But it's more nuanced than that. It's like no one's saying that white lives don't matter.
Everybody should support it. I said, why wouldn't you support it when it's about equality? And other people will pit it against police officers, right? They'll mm-hmm. say, oh, if you're saying that you're part of the Black Lives Matter movement, that you hate police officers. That's not true at all. We're just saying that there needs to be reform. We know there's good police officers out there, but also, can we make sure that there's more training?
I want people to be held responsible. If your job as a police officer is to hold people responsible for when they do bad things, mm-hmm. I would hope that you would be held responsible if you do bad things.
Yeah,
and you shouldn't fight against something that is intended to hold you accountable.
And, you know, Beyonce was criticized that people felt she wasn't speaking out enough when a lot of these shootings were happening. And that's what I loved about this video, was that it was pretty much her
way
saying exactly through her art, saying exactly how she feels, and, you know, being sort of a beacon showing this example and showing her pride in being, you know, black. And I think that
I love that.
I thought that was awesome.
People don't make videos like this as much anymore. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I mean, I don't remember the song, but I remember the images. And I think that just means that it was a very successful music video.
We should bring up, since we're talking about this, because I believe this just came out this morning, that some of the footage that they took came from a couple of independent film producers. And they were not, they took that footage, apparently, according to these film producers, without either giving them credit for the likeness of it or even asking them. So the
Beyonce, I said, straight up. Beyonce.
So those film producers are.
She probably said, "Let's steal that footage." I'm mm-hmm. Beyonce.
Yeah.
It's not stealing because I own it all.
Never trusted her. Never liked her.
I hate her.
I believe those film producers tweeted something about, "Hey, you know, could you give us some credit?" And then they tweeted that the credit that some of that footage was taken from that independent film. So I think since we're talking about it, we might as well include the whole conversation. So, anyways.
Now I don't like her anymore.
Let us know what you think of Formation. Leave your thoughts in the comment section below, and we'll see you guys all next time on Pop Trigger.